prehab, rehab, and doing what you thought was impossible. What's up, guys? It's Nate Johnson. So this is week two of the Fix My Shoulder project. This is video two in the series. So just want to give you guys an update and remind you of what I'm doing, what I have going on. I had some clicking in my left shoulder. You know, just anteriorly rotated, dumping forward, shoulders up and in, like a lot of you guys are, from sitting all day, and wasn't doing enough pulling in my program, enough pull-ups, rows, things like that. And one thing I've never addressed are my external rotators, part of the scapula, doing this. So any kind of like external, let's see if you guys can get that in the shot. There we go. External rotation like that. The external rotators are a very small muscle group. And there's only two muscles that externally rotate, to my knowledge. Everything else, all the big powerful muscles are going to internally rotate, because a lot of the stuff that we do is in front of us. You know, we're not reaching back behind ourselves to do things unless you're like a parent trying to smack your kid, get him to shut up in the back seat while you're driving. So there's not a whole lot of things that we do external rotation for. So those a lot of times are weak and underdeveloped, and the internal rotators are tight. So anyway, so what I've been doing to prevent this clicking, and to bring my shoulders down and back, just working on my posture, first of all, still not 100% on that. Doing a lot more rowing, a lot of high volume rowing, lots of pull-ups, lots of rows. Stretching of the pec major, the big one, pec minor up here near the collarbone, on the anterior, the front of the shoulder, anterior deltoid. So I'm stretching those out and doing a lot of strengthening for my external rotators and just upper back, face pulls, things like that. So the update is good. I hit a PR on incline bench. My shoulder feels a lot more stable, so I'm able to produce more power. That being said, it still kind of gave out at the end, and again, wouldn't stay back, kind of dumped forward a little bit on the last rep, but I was very fatigued. Like I said, it was a PR and it was close to failure, so I'm still very happy with the results, but I could still have some work to do. The clicking has seriously gone down. Any kind of minor pain or nuisance I was feeling on the shoulder is gone. So it's working really well. And I've included a couple videos of some exercise I've been doing, just so you guys can check that out. But I think it's just a testament to the fact that unless you're like post-surgery, you know, that would exclude you from this. But if you've just got a minor ache and pain or a minor issue, you can usually fix it in 4 weeks or less, maybe 6 weeks, but you're not looking at months and months, close to a year for like you are if something gets seriously snapped up. The problem is when you ignore something that's minor, that is when you end up snapping something up and you end up needing surgery or have a long, long recovery ahead of you. So stay healthy, stay strong, and check out the rest of the video. Hope you guys enjoy it. And I will be posting week three and week four, and really as long as I need until I get back to 100%. So you guys enjoy. About to do the world's first 100 rep dip set, 75 pounds. Okay. Trying to fix my snapped up shoulder. All right, guys, so this is a reverse shrug. And so instead of shrugging up, we're taking our shoulders from the up and elevated position and we're shoving them down, which is gonna be working those muscles that keep the shoulders down and back, which is what we want. In this next video, you're gonna see the second set after I set my PR on the incline bench press. This one was 135 for 9 reps.